we have recorded first video that was how to identify and understand the type of errors. Now certain scenarios are given in this worksheet, and we will see what type of error existing in it. If you're performing the experiment of heat, if you're performing the experiment of light, if you're performing the experiment of electricity, if you're performing the experiment of physical quantities and measurement, and kinematics, even dynamics, whatever experiment you are performing in mechanics, current electricity, thermal physics, and measurement, we will see what type of error is or source of error is it. Starting from first, the gas tap stopped working during an experiment. The gas tap stopped working during an experiment is a type of error which was not existing in the system. It is not related to environmental error as well. It is something happens during the experiment considered to be random error. So if we will see, it's a random error. Second is the scale was misread on the measuring cylinder. Scale was misread on the measuring cylinder. This is done by the experimenter. So experimenter error is a type we discuss in random error, that is human error. So it is also random error. Now, the timer was started just before the acid was added to the flask. You take the stopwatch, but the timer started before you have done the experiment. So it is taken as systematic error. So systematic error is in this way. The gas tap was turned off during an experiment. It's a repetition. It's a random error. The thermometer was read at the wrong angle. So it is human error, which is also taken as random error. You're going to read it at a wrong position. The ammeter reading was 0.2 ampere when no current was flowing through it. So it's a systematic error. Your system is not working properly. I'm going to repeat it. The ammeter reading was 0.2 ampere when no current was flowing through it. So it's a systematic error. The battery in the stopwatch ran out during the experiment. It's not your fault, nor the system faults. It's overall happening during the experiment, so considered as random error. The wires in the circuit had poor connection. You can rectify them, or you are not knowing about it. So it's also considered as random error. The bubbles were too small and moving quickly to count. So in an experiment, the bubbles were too small. That it's error of the system, systematic error, that they are too small and moving too quickly. So next, the temperature of the room increases or increased during the course of experiment. The temperature is environmental factor. So it means this is under the umbrella or shadow of which type of error? Environmental error. Three drops were added to the test tube instead of one. So an experimenter is performing an experiment. So it is his or her fault to add three drops instead of one. So it is taken as random error, and under random error, it is considered as human error. So random human error. So it's the last point here is about there was a draft coming through the window whilst measuring the temperature of a boiling tube. So you can see that the air is blowing, wind is blowing through the window, and you are performing the experiment. You are measuring the temperature of a boiling tube. So it is also associated with the environmental error. So students, these were some scenarios given for you, and these scenarios are involving random error, systematic error, and last but not least, environmental error. Other scenarios can also be given to you. In the next video, we will see that how you can say that this measurement is showing which type of error. If you are performing the experiment, in an experiment you have calculated a value, how you will check by analyzing the final result that this type of error is existing and we have to eliminate it. We'll see you in the next video. Take care. Have a nice day.